This is the first chapter of standard 10. I'm starting with the topic force, work, energy and power. Today I will complete the topic force, kinds of forces, linear motion, rotational motion and moment of force. Listen carefully. Open page 1. Force is an external effort in the form of push or pull, which changes or tends to change the state of rest or of uniform motion of a body along a straight line, or the direction of motion of the body, or changes or tends to change the shape of the body. This is not the new topic for you. You have been learning since standard 6 what is force. Means force can change the state of a body. It can change the shape, size, direction, speed. Everything can be changed. These all can be changed by force. Its SI unit is Newton, CGS unit is Dyne. You just recall there are two kinds of forces, contact force and non-contact force. Contact force is that force which is exerted on an object by another when it is in direct contact with it. Examples: tension in a string, frictional force between two surfaces, normal reaction, etc. Here you can see frictional force exists between two surfaces when they are in contact. That is between our feet and the road, between the tire and the road. Normal reaction, when you keep a book on the table exerts normal reaction force on the book and the book exerts its weight on the table. So when this is exerted when both are in contact. Similarly, non-contact force is that force which is acting between two objects when they are not in contact. Examples: gravitational force of attraction between two bodies, electrical force of attraction or repulsion between charged objects, magnetic force of attraction or repulsion between two magnetized objects. You know, gravitational force can be exerted from far. It is always exerted from far. When you throw an object upward, it returns back to the ground due to gravitational force when the ground and the body is not at all in contact, but it is being exerted. Magnet can attract magnetic material, mainly iron, from far. So it is non-contact force. Charge objects. Charge objects also means charged particles, if we consider when a comb is rubbed against dry hair. After that, if it is kept near the pieces of paper from far, many of you might have noticed that papers are getting attracted. This is the electrical force. Now we'll discuss two types of motions created due to the application of force. Number one, linear or translational motion, and number two, rotational motion. Linear motion is created when a force acts on a stationary rigid body which is free to move. The body starts moving in a straight path in the direction of force. You can look at this diagram. When a force is applied on a ball, see the diagram here, the ball moves forward in the straight line. If it is not getting obstructed, it will move, keep on moving in the straight line. So this is the example of translational motion. Another example, you see, on pushing a car, suppose, pushing a car, toy car you can consider, a vehicle you can consider, from back if it is pushed, it will go forward, means it will move on a straight line. So this kind of these are the kinds of examples of linear motion, means due to the application of force, body is moving on the straight line. Now, second type of motion is rotational motion. If a body is pivoted at a point and a force is applied on the body at a suitable point, it rotates the body about the axis passing through the pivoted point. This is the turning effect of the force, and the motion is called rotational motion. It can be very clear with the help of an example. See the wheel. All of you have seen wheel or vehicles or toys or any other. Wheel is always pivoted about a fixed point, that is called center. Now if you look at this diagram, see the direction of force here. When the force is applied on this wheel at that particular point, the wheel keeps on moving clockwise direction. So as it is moving about the axis, so it is called rotational motion. Now we will discuss regarding moment of force. Turning effect of a force acting on an object about an axis is called moment of force or torque. Mathematically, moment of force or the torque exerted by the force about the point is the product of the applied force and the perpendicular distance of its line of action from the point about which the object is free to rotate. Listen, this one you have to understand with the help of an example. Every day you see the opening and closing of door in your house. Single door, I'm talking about single door. One side of single door is fixed, and other side of the door is movable. When you try to open the door, what you do? You apply force other at the end of the door, means another side of the door where it is free to move. You apply the force, and due to that force, either it opens or it closes. Here, the turning effect means the rotational motion is created here. The turning effect depends on, it will turn easily or it will be difficult to turn. That depends on two factors. How much force you apply and at what distance from the hinges you apply the force. More is the force you apply, more will be the turning effect, or more is the distance from the hinges to the application of force, point of application of force, more will be the turning effect. So you might have noticed, if you try to apply the force one extreme end of the door, you can open it easily. But if you try to open the door by applying force at the middle of the door, then you find little difficult. In these two cases, when you apply the force at the extreme end, then perpendicular distance is more, and so the turning effect is more. But if you are applying the force at the middle of the door, then the perpendicular distance from the hinge to the point of application of force I'm talking about, that distance will be less. So the turning effect will be less. So regarding the measurement, moment of force is equal to force into perpendicular distance. Alright. So its SI unit is for force Newton and for distance meter. So Newton. There are two types of moment of forces: clockwise and anti-clockwise. If the effect on the body is to turn it anti-clockwise, the moment of force is called anti-clockwise moment, and it is taken positive. While if the effect on the body is to turn it clockwise, The moment of force is called clockwise moment and it is taken negative. The moment of force is a vector quantity. Underline this point. The moment of force is a vector quantity. Here these 2 points also you have to remember. I am telling you one by one those points. You kindly underline and memorize at home. Clockwise moment and anti-clockwise moment. Definitions, which one is taken as positive, which one is taken as negative. What is moment of force? Its measurement, that is moment of force equal to force into perpendicular distance. Its SI unit, Newton meter. And moment of force depends on which factors? Number one, force. And number two, the perpendicular distance of the line of action of the force from the axis of rotation. These are the points you learn very nicely. And see here, this relations also important. It may be asked to derive the relation between the SI unit and CGS unit of moment of force. That is the relation between Newton meter and dyne centimeter. Newton meter is the SI unit of moment of force. Dyne centimeter is the SI unit of CGS unit of moment of force. As we know, 1 Newton equal to 10 to the power 5 dyne. So you substitute 10 to the power 5 in place of 1 Newton. And we know 1 meter equal to 100 centimeter. So in place of meter, you substitute 10 to the power 2 or 100 centimeter. Finally, adding the powers, we get 10 to the power 7 dyne centimeter. Two more relations we will memorize. 1 kgf into meter equal to 9.8 Newton meter and 1 gf into centimeter equal to 980 dyne centimeter. Okay, children. Thank you.